There you go.
Thank you for everybody for attending. I also want to express my appreciation for the flexibility on the rescheduling of this call. Let me start by saying I want to remind everybody the audit, this is the audit selection committee that was formed in January to assist the town in selecting an auditor to conduct the annual audit in accordance with Florida statutes. Requests for RFPs, were issued in February. Subsequently, the town received two proposals. Purpose of today's meeting is to evaluate and rank the two firms and then finally making recommendations to the town commission. As part of the due diligence process, the town staff called references and did some independent research. Those findings were shared with each of the committee members. Before getting into the discussion, I would like to thank Grau and Associates and Nolan, Holt, and Minor for the proposals. I know it takes a lot of time and we appreciate it. I think the best way to kick it off, if it's okay with Linda and Tracy, is to ask each of them to share with this group their thoughts as it relates to the two proposals and the two firms. Linda, you want to start? I can see you.
Okay, I'll start. As far as the two firms, I used the evaluation form and the RFP that was submitted. I had many of the areas that they were ranked very similarly. I had two areas of concern on the Grau as opposed to the Nolan Holt. The availability of key personnel, I ranked them lower than Nolan Holt. And my concern was that the hours that they proposed to perform the audit were much lower than the hours that Nolan was proposing. And I know Nolan has been doing your audit, so they have a general idea of how long it takes to perform your audit. So I felt that Grau had underestimated the amount of time that it would take, especially as a new auditor. It's certainly going to take a lot longer for them to get up to speed for the first year or two. So I ranked them much lower at that point. I also, at the location, they have 9 of 15 CPAs, Grau, whereas Nolan Holt has a much larger group of CPAs there that have experience that I felt would provide a better service. With the rates, I know that Grau was lower, but they were lower based on the total number of hours. As opposed to their hourly rates, they were much higher than Nolan Holt. Their partners were at 225, where Nolan Holt was at 195. The manager was at 175 and Nolan Holt was 160. The supervisory staff was 150 and Nolan Holt used the staff and other admin. They had 132 hours to perform the audit where Grau had 90, which is a significant difference in number of hours. I also had one question, and I don't know if you all know that. Is the true digital included in the bid? I didn't see that it was part of the structure, but they said that it was going to be included. Do you know anything about that, Rebecca?
I don't think that it was included. I think that it was an optional additional thing that we can opt into. So
okay, that was one of the, because it didn't indicate and I couldn't tell, but they kept referencing it and saying what a good service it was to provide and how it would help you. So I didn't know that much about that one. So my ranking, based on the information that I just gave you, is I ranked Grau with a possible score of 90, and I ranked Nolan Holt with a score of 96. So they came in much higher than Grau for those reasons that I gave you.
Would you give me those numbers again, Linda? I apologize.
I ranked Grau at 90, mm-hmm. and I ranked Nolan Holt at 96.
Thank you.
And I will tell you that the references, after speaking with Greg and Rebecca and hearing what reference information they got, that's what I used to rank the references also.
Maybe I should move to any other comments, Linda?
No, that's it for now, unless someone has any questions.
A good summation summary. Tracy, are you there?
Yep, I'm here. Can you hear me?
I can. Would you kindly share your thoughts?
Absolutely. And it's really going to sound almost a carbon copy of what Linda talked about. As I was listening to you, I'm looking at my notes and they're almost exact. So my first thing that I saw under the qualifications and experience was that Nolan Holton Minor was going to assign a partner full time, whereas Grau was going to have a partner available for technical assistance. So I scored Grau lower in that area because of that. And same as Linda said, they had more CPAs on staff at Nolan Holton Minor. Also, the rates, even though the overall bid seemed to be higher for Nolan Holton Minor, if you look at the actual rate, it's due to the fact that the rate for the partner for Grau is $225, whereas it's $195 for Nolan Holton Minor. And Nolan Holton Minor uses their staff and admin to do certain things at the lower rate. So that was my other comment. And then also availability of key personnel. It looks like Grau has a really big client list, and I was concerned that they may not be able to provide the adequate personnel and the key, you know, with the partner and everything, whereas Nolan Holton Minor does. And also the hours looked like they were underestimated in Grau's proposal. Let's see. I also, when I was reviewing the Grau proposal, when I was looking at litigation, it wasn't clear in their proposal as to whether they ever had any litigation. It shows no litigation for the past 3 years. So I'm just where Nolan Holton Minors has listed that they have never had any litigation. Okay. Let's see. Another thing that stood out to me, and I don't know, this might be a question, but it looked like the Grau proposal was only a 90-day proposal, which has expired.
I thought the same things, Tracy, when I looked at it. I thought, are those prices still good?
Right. So that's what I was wondering on that as well. That's just a question for me. My overall scores, Grau and Associates, I scored a total of 94 points, and Nolan Holton Minor, I scored 99.
Well, thank you all for that input. I don't really have any additional insight to the comments from Tracy and Linda, but I'll summarize my thoughts as well. And it is going to be a little repetitive. Generally, the overall depth and experience of Nolan, I thought was stronger than Grau. I also agree with the observations that the amount of time it's going to take is going to be greater, particularly for a new firm. The allocation of key resources, personnel, seemed to be a little better at was better at Nolan. And I guess the final comment when it comes to price, I do agree with Linda and Tracy that while the total price was less, the hourly rates for the individuals was higher at Grau. So my numbers are more like 94 for Nolan and 88 for Grau. So it would seem that there's a consensus, both in terms of the individual criteria, as well as the total score, that Nolan is the firm that would be the one we would recommend to the town commission. Linda and Tracy, would you agree with that?
I would agree with it, yes. That would be my
Okay, so Trey, is there any particular action that we need to take at this meeting? Let me summarize that the findings in terms of the evaluation ranking is as follows, that Nolan is the firm that the three members of the committee would recommend to the town commission to do the annual audit.
Yeah, and that's sufficient for the purposes of determining that they are the most highly qualified and that you will recommend them to the commission at the upcoming meeting.
Okay. Well, I find that what's been a very good process. It is interesting, without any collaboration amongst the three members, that we individually and independently came to this same similar conclusions. My background is very different from Linda and Tracy. A lot of time with private corporations and lots of audits. So I understand it clearly, and it was nice that, and I want to thank Linda and Tracy for their insight and experience on this subject. Without them, I don't think we would have arrived at the right conclusion. So thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
If there's no other business, I think this concludes the meeting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Thank you.
Let's get out of here. Okay.